Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky in the laboratory with a little clinic on the Iwata Neo, which just landed late yesterday from our good friends over at Iwata. And I want to thank Bill and Tom and John, you know who you are, for making this happen. I had not really thought much about the Neo, and but it's a gorgeous you know, gun, and we're gonna see it. It's still sealed, and basically it's, you know, it says Neo for Iwata. Start airbrushing now with the Neo series only from Iwata. The Neo series are versatile, value-priced airbrushes that can be used with a variety of different paints and mediums. Plus, they're easy to use and easy to clean. Iwata designed the Neo series airbrushes to perform well at lower air pressures when used with smaller air compressors. Iwata backs the Neo series airbrushes with an unprecedented 5-year warranty. And then it goes on to tell you exactly what it does and what hobbies, all of that. Here it says features a unique 0.35 millimeter needle and nozzle combination for finer detail spraying and medium sized spray patterns. Includes interchangeable large 1/3 ounce and medium 1/16 ounce cups designed with a funnel shape, which makes for easy cleanup and more efficient paint flow. Airbrush will hold 1/32 ounce without a cup attached. So lots of options, and we are going to crack it open. We've been salivating to do this. You know, as always, everything from Iwata comes professionally packaged and beautifully packaged. And if you don't believe me now, wait until you see the Micron C that I have, where the packaging is just, it's a piece of art. Anyway, so here it is. It's a double action airbrush, and it comes with this little foam insert, which is actually very good. It maintains, you know, never throw your original packaging, because you'll see. I mean, it's it helps keep all the you know, all the parts in place and in good shape, so you know you could store your airbrush when you are done. And they have a nice little diagram here of what double action basically means. Where was this diagram when I was doing it on the previous video? But anyway, you press down, that releases air and pressure, and then you pull back, and it releases the paint. The further back, of course, the more paint flow. Already you can tell these are the elements that come with it. And just, you know, the smaller cup. And, of course, here it is, the machine itself. This is the needle tip removing little wrench. I have a few of these. That's why you need to keep it, so you always know exactly where it is. Oh my goodness, it's humid in here. Look at that, it's fogging up. That's the sound you always want to hear, you know, from your airbrush when it's nice and clean. Just it feels like every other Iwata airbrush. It's got a nice heft, nice feel on the hand, you know. The crown cap, you have to be very careful. There is the needle tip, great movement. I mean, it's just it's like any other Iwata airbrush. But the beauty of the Neo, and this is where it gets competitive, the price is excellent. So it's at the level, it's about 60, give or take a few more dollars, And so it competes with directly with Pache and Badger, and again, this is what we use. I like Iwata. I've always loved them. It's the airbrush that I learned to use and get great results with. I know how it works. I know how to assemble it, disassemble it, you know, all of that good stuff. And so I am looking forward to doing some test sprays with this. I'll put a little adapter on there, a quick disconnect. And then, of course, the beauty of this one is that if you're doing a lot of spraying, then you use the larger cup, okay? If you're doing, which is mostly a lot of the detail when we do template work, a lot of the detail we do, it's a smaller cup that we use. Or in this case, and this is the beauty of it, you get, in essence, you get 3-in-1. You can just, put your paint in there directly, eyedropper, and then go with that. So you don't really need that much paint. I mean, if you're applying primer and clear and base coats, yeah, you're gonna need probably the larger cup. But for template work and graphic detailing, this will see you through. So for the first time, you know, we get an airbrush that you can basically just adapt to your needs right on the spot. So very pleased with it, and I'm very anxious to give it a try. So look for it, you know, check it out. It's, as I said, it has a very competitive price. You no longer have to, say, oh my God, you know, I can't afford an Iwata because it's over $127. This is in the highly affordable range, my friends. So good value and good product for your money. You have a tool that's going to last you for a long, long time. And once we test it, we're going to talk a little bit more in detail about the air pressure thing and some of the paints in terms of viscosity and flow and all of that. So once we take it out for the test drive, which is another video that will be coming up soon here in the series, then we will address those issues. But for the time being, very impressed with this airbrush. And again, the Iwata quality is there. And I love it. I mean, I'm going to use it and enjoy it for many years to come. So check it out and report back. You know, we love to hear what your own experience is, experiences are with this particular airbrush. It's brand new to me, so I'm anxious to take it out for a spin. All right, my friends, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory. Wishing you all well, and I hope you stay tuned in. There'll be more reviews and more tools being brought to you. All right.